Thoughts on my new shirt, Alice?
I like your new shirt. Is this part of you becoming Serbian?
This is part of me becoming Serbian,
Alice. I like it. I'm a fan.
Thank you very much.
Being Serbian.
Do you realize what this reads?
It says sa.
What?
That's the Serbian letter. It's a C, but it's pronounced like an S all the time.
These here?
Mm-hmm.
And what does that mean?
It stands for Samo sloga Srbina spasava.
Which means?
Only unity saves the Serbs.
Ah! Do you agree with that?
Yeah, why not? And then that's like the double-headed eagle is like a Byzantine thing.
Yes, and I know what Byzantine means, but some of the listeners probably don't. So
it's the Eastern Roman Empire that continued on for another 1,000 years after Rome fell.
Naturally.
Just saying. But the people in the Byzantine Empire would not have necessarily identified as part of the Byzantine Empire, which went up to those parts of the Balkans at times. But they would have identified as Romans, really, because they considered they, you know, Rome became an Eastern Empire and a Western Empire. It split into two halves.
I remember you saying this, Alice.
And then
one part fizzled out and one part kept on. Did they not realize that the dream was over? The empire was done?
Their dream wasn't over. They still had emperors.
Okay.
They still had emperors.
I am not one of those guys who thinks of the Roman Empire. I know nothing about it.
you're more of a World War II kind of person, generally speaking.
Exactly.
But you could start to get into it. It's pretty cool.
I could. You know what? I might do that. It's about time. I've been circling around it for a long time now.
Getting into Rome in general or like the Byzantine Empire?
The Roman Empire. The whole story of that part of the earth.
It's pretty great. And your daughter's into it right now because of the Percy Jackson books.
Right.
So they have
my deep dive into
Greeks and Romans. Yes.
Into the French Revolution was especially helpful, actually, considering it's very timely. Mm-hmm. I guess a lot
Although,
of
Although kind of short-lived. You're like, you went on a French Revolution bender and then you just stopped. Like, there's been no more French Revolution in this house for a while.
Yeah, I mean, you know, this was mostly watching YouTube documentaries, etc. Mm-hmm. And some were better than others.
Right.
But I went through.
There's probably books about all these things, too.
Yeah.
I'm just making a suggestion.
What year do you think this is, Mr. Bonk?
I know.
Okay,
this
Alice.
This explains why you didn't know what Claude meant for years and years. Because you would have had to open a book to find out before there were online dictionaries.
I have read a smattering of books, Alice. I find them arduous, tedious, and I don't want to escape anywhere. So I do want to get to a couple of things. File this under things that I find delicious, even though it's the end of civilization.
Okay.
This is in Connecticut, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Mm-hmm.
A place that has a bit of a reputation of having kind of dirty politics, shady elections. The current mayor of Bridgeport, Connecticut, in like 2003 or something, did a federal stint for taking bribes, whatever.
Okay.
Then went to jail and then came back and then won the mayor.
Of course.
See, exactly. But now there's this incredible video showing a woman who worked for this mayor stuffing ballots into a ballot box. It's incredible.
First tonight, explosive video in the Bridgeport mayor's race. It appears to show a woman stuffing stacks of absentee votes into a ballot box. And now one candidate wants the whole primary election tossed out. News 12 Connecticut's John Craven has been on top of this. He's in the alert center right now. So John, this all happened right in front of the mayor's office?
Yeah, brazen, right, Brittany? That absentee ballot box is right in front of the Bridgeport Government Center. And once again, Mayor Joe Ganim is fighting accusations of ballot violations.
Ganim's opponent posted the leaked security camera video to social media over the weekend.
Shows a person walking over with a bag full of ballots, stuffing them into the ballots.
Mm-hmm.
This has, Gannon's opponent, of course, is not taking this well.
Masking for a new primary, given the content of it.
John
Ganim says police are investigating both the actions on the video and the leak. In a statement tonight, he says, I want to state unequivocally that I do not condone in any way actions taken by anyone, including...
Ganem is a Democrat. The opponent, of course, is a Democrat. This is a primary fight. And this is Ned Lamont, the governor of the state, was asked about this.
Reports to the mayor.
Today, Governor Lamont called for swift action.
He looks very uncomfortable.
I saw those videos. They were disturbing. That said, don't jump to conclusions. I say that every time. But I really want to thoroughly investigate this.
Ganem's last win in 2019 was plagued with absentee ballot allegations. But a judge...
No, this is what I want to say about this.
Okay.
I am declaring that Bridgeport had the cleanest elections in the history of the city, nay, of democratic civilization. These were the cleanest elections ever. Ned Lamont wanting to look at the video. What is he? 2,000 mules suddenly?
Right.
No, this is the cleanest election ever. These are election deniers. These are white supremacists, and these are insurrectionists. You're not allowed to question election. These are
Can
election
we understand
deniers.
That that's like literally Jim Eagle?
Yes, I have no problem with this. I find the elections to be perfect. I think they should happen this way all the time. Democrats, this is what you want. This is the world as you've set this table. Enjoy it. I think it's wonderful. I do not hear. I do not have a bit of sympathy for these people. They've created this world, and since they've made my life worse because of it, I am going to enjoy every bit of it. Burn it all down. Burn it all down. And burn it all down. And you know what? While you're at it...
Drive, create a new partnership.
Your president...
Mm-hmm.
Speaking at the UN...
Yeah.
This is your guy. You got him. Enjoy him.
Now, we need to evolve our institutions and drive creative new partnerships. Let me be clear. Certain principles of our international system are sacrosanct.
There you go.
Stop making fun of his stutter.
I'm absolutely all for it. I think it's wonderful. The Democrats, chickens.
I know. And it's across the board. I mean, like, it's not just Biden. It's not just Ned Lamont and Bridgeport, Connecticut. Did you see the Fetterman cut?
I've seen a couple
with the auto workers.
My message to the CEOs is, you know, it's $74 million, you know, collectively earning that. You know, how many yachts can they need, to ski behind it? You know, I mean, it's crazy. You know, I don't know. This is my message.
Yep. No problem.
It's great. It's fine. He just has a hearing problem. Why do you have such a problem with it? Didn't you know that strokes affect your hearing?
Yeah.
Not your brain.
By the way, and the fact that he's lumbering a lot around in some big jumper suits for zombies, I'm all for that too. CBS News YouGov poll found that just 20% of voters think they are better off today than they were when the pandemic struck, whereas 45% said they are worse off today, and 35% say they are about the same. Biden's economic record, summarized by the president himself as Bidenomics, is likely to be a key point of contention in the 2024 election poll. I also think, by the way, that Trump tacking to the kind of middle, almost nowhere, but somewhat somewhere thing is on abortion is good. I don't think anybody really thinks that he's a religious man. I think that the evangelicals are going to stand by him for life because he nuked Roe v. Wade.
Well, he nuked Roe v. Wade, and I obviously disagree with him when he says heartbeat bills are terrible. I think that's crazy. Like, I want to see more heartbeat bills and people.
That's just a hit to sanctimonious.
Yeah. But people who've passed heartbeat bills have gotten elected by huge margins, including DeSantis, including Mike DeWine in Ohio, including a bunch of them. I mean, we have a political system where you elect representatives and they pass bills. And, you know, that's how it goes. And I don't think that most of the people complaining about these bills have been affected by them in any way whatsoever. I think most of the harms of all of this are being imagined by like suburban women in Massachusetts who imagine that they're somehow being harmed by DeSantis'
right.
heartbeat bill. So, I mean, like, first of all, people are having like less intimate relationships than ever and having fewer unplanned pregnancies than ever to start with. So abortion was like already sort of declining anyway, just because, I mean, overall fertility is declining. So fewer pregnancies means fewer abortions, which is good. I would like to see us have a 15-week national ban. I think that's reasonable. I think that's like where most people are. I think that that could absolutely be popular. It's on par with what they have in Europe mm-hmm. and everywhere else, with the option for states to go deeper. Would I eventually like to see a national abortion ban? Like, yeah, but, you know, for better or worse.
You mean you would want federal legislation?
Yeah, I would want federal legislation. I mean, I would want to see, I mean, I would want to see the Supreme Court say that a baby's a baby, so like you can't kill it, like you have a right to be alive, just like you can't kill your kid. I mean, I
right.
you know, there's the I would like to see a right to life recognized by the court, but which isn't what they did, you know, but that's my view. And I recognize that for better or worse, we live in a country where you have to get people to a consensus view.
Yes.
Because that's how our political system works. So, you know, you have to convince other people that it's worth getting there, right?
Like, right.
And a lot of people in this country just aren't there yet. So, yeah, I mean, I think it's probably politically helpful to him to be more moderate on abortion. Do I think the left cares? No, they're still going to slam him as too pro-life. But does it help that, you know, I forget which show it was. Was it NBC that essentially said, you know, like nobody says that. Nobody wants abortion up to birth. That's not even a thing. And then Gavin Newsom has been on TV this week refusing to say when he would ever place any limit on abortion whatsoever.
Right.
So, like, I mean, clearly it's not true that people advocate for abortion up to birth, because in the Democratic Party, they want zero restrictions on abortions.
Yes. No, that's absolutely true.
That's the mainstream Democratic Party.
And that, by the way, is the answer to when somebody says, if you're a Republican, oh, if a person is raped or murdered or the life of the mother, can we, whatever, you explain to them that we're talking about advocating for a child that would be recognized as a baby and just trying to save those lives. Republicans, mm-hmm. shame on them for being ill prepared for this. And to
yeah.
the argument, the
no, the they're actual the dog that like finally caught yeah. the car. And I know people use that metaphor, but like it's totally true. Trump's not the only person in the Republican Party who talked a lot of talk about being pro-life and then didn't actually believe it. And so when the moment came when Roe v. Wade was repealed, like a lot of them didn't have anything to say either. At least Trump goes out there and says it's great that I overturned Roe v. Wade, and
right.
is saying it and is trying to defend it, because he's not wrong when he says Republicans talk about it really badly, and that's because a lot of them don't believe it either. A lot of them don't believe
maybe
it.
Maybe that just goes to show you that for Republicans, Trump was not just for the Beltway, Trump was not just a threat to Democrats status quo. He was a threat to the Republican status quo because mm-hmm. he helped them realize some of their policy goals that they were comfortable in knowing never would be realized.
Oh yeah, take Obamacare too. How many times did they repeal Obamacare when there was
right.
no chance anything would happen? You know, they don't know what to do when somebody actually
it's the mindset of a permanent minority party, which Massachusetts has.
Yeah.
And Connecticut has too.
Mm-hmm. So they're not interested in doing real things. I mean, does Trump swing, in my opinion, sometimes too much the other way? Like when he talks about wanting to get things done with Democrats? I think that's true. Look at the beginning of his pregnancy. I have pregnancy on the brain, obviously. Look at the beginning of his presidency, where he passed the First Step Act and all this stuff, and where mm-hmm. I mean, like, if Democrats had turned around and embraced Trump and gone to go try and get a bunch of policy priorities done with him that they wanted to get done, we would be having completely different conversations about this right now, because he absolutely, he just wants people to like him. You know, he would have done this stuff with them, with them too, but he was so hated by them, and they're so irrationally upset about Donald Trump, like, not for anything real. Like, they upset themselves about him.
Now, can I do something? I want to go local with something. This is WTNH channel. This is local, is in Connecticut. This is a study in the media, and a study in the media, politics, and culture.
Mm-hmm. When Welcome back, Pride New Haven starts today in the Elm City.
Big smiles from
a week-long celebration.
She's smiling too.
Of LGBTQ culture and community.
News 8's Natasha Luchenko has a look at how the event is kicking off today.
Natasha, big smile.
Natasha, good morning.
Hi, guys. Good morning to you both. This is the 25th year that this festival is happening right here in the Elm City. It's also one of the largest LGBTQ plus events around the state. It all starts today right here on the New Haven Green at 1 p.m.
All starts
Justin
today.
Justin Ellicker will be joining the New Haven Pride Center for a flag-raising ceremony. That is just the first event of the week. We're going to pull up a full screen here.
The full screen says, today, flag-raising ceremony. Tuesday, Pride Volunteer Day. Wednesday, Drag Artist Story Hour. Right? Saturday, Pride Block Party. Sunday, I love how drag people are now artists. They're the most talented fat losers that I've ever seen in my life. Sunday, Pride Barbecue. And anyway, this whole thing is
other events, a celebration.
Can I just ask, why is this happening right now? Wasn't Pride Month in June?
That's different. New Haven gets that too, but they also get their own Pride Week too.
So they're
raising the pride flag, et cetera. But I just want you to listen, work with me
okay,
here.
Okay, yep, I am.
All
I just
positive.
Was curious.
Now, there is no, this is all promotional. There
oh, yeah.
is no asking anybody who doesn't want this. There's no talking to anybody like this. They are all in.
Can I mention one more thing before you get fully into this story here too? Is the more I listen to reporters try and say LGBTQ plus culture or whatever with a straight face, or Justin Trudeau say 2S LGBTQI plus or whatever it is, the more I think that the left deliberately makes things absurd and ridiculous on purpose, like as a troll and a test.
They do.
Of
There's been
loyalty.
Three anchors on this story, and they've all said a different version because nobody's got the updated note.
2S LGBTQI plus.
They're not even caught up to him, and he's now moved on from that one.
Right, and they're everybody's like afraid of getting it wrong and trying to do it right and all this stuff.
And trying to do it matter-of-factly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's a really common noted thing, you know?
Yeah, but it's the same with, like, the stolen land confessions at the beginning of stuff that you say if you're, like, on the stolen land of whoever. Like, it's a deliberate humiliation ritual.
Yes.
That you have to do to, like, prove. And everybody knows it's absurd.
Yes.
The people watching you know that it's absurd. All this stuff. Why are my cameras frozen? And the more I hear people do it, the more I think, like, they just keep sticking letters on there.
That's
to
right.
Mess with
and there's
people.
Obviously somebody like in HR, right, firing off memos to the anchors and the news staff and the, you know, saying, hey, producers, it's really up to you to make sure the talent near you is up to date on the latest. And so that's about New Haven Pride. Now, there's also another Pride thing. There's another symbolic theme thing happening in Torrington, Connecticut. This one's a little bit different. This one doesn't get the smile to smile to smile.
Right.
This one gets concerned from the reporters, and this one does get both sides. This is, you know, in New Haven, it wasn't New Haven officials defend Pride flag and Pride Week. It was New Haven celebrates kickoff to LGBTQI plus ampersand. It's a happy thing. Now, for Torrington, this has to do with a Christian flag. This is the headline. Torrington officials defend Christian flag raising at City Hall. Now, it's not Christian flag raising begins Christian Appreciation Week in Torrington. No. It's Torrington officials defend. And the tone is extremely, extremely
30
different.
Torrington officials are defending the decision to allow a Christian flag on the City Hall flag.
This lady is not smiling. This anchor.
Right. She is serious.
Yes, she's concerned.
Paul, the flag went up in a ceremony this weekend, and city officials did research in anticipation of backlash about a religious symbol being used on public property.
Now, the flag went up in a ceremony this weekend. Wouldn't she then add some color about the ceremony? No. People put her up.
Went up in a ceremony this weekend, and city officials did research in anticipation of backlash about a
religious... No, that's, they did research in anticipation of backlash. No right. color about the ceremony or the what mm-hmm. that means to people or whatever. Just, yeah, they were ready for the backlash that they rightfully are getting.
Religious symbol being used on public property. And as Channel 3 Waterbury Bureau Chief Audrey Russo explains...
Religious symbol being used on public property.
There is legal precedent for allowing the flag to fly.
Torrington City Hall's flagpole is featuring a different take on the red, white, and blue.
The white for the, you know, the cleansing of our sins, the blue, the background of the earth, and the red cross, the blood of Christ.
The pastor of the First Congregational Church, Stephen Darr, says his church asked to fly this flag on the city's flagpole for 2 weeks in collaboration with different denominations and in celebration of the faith community.
A different take on the red, white, and blue.
Yeah.
Now, hold on. There's been no mention of another flag yet.
Right.
In this package. Let's see when it comes.
Communities work to provide different services to people in Torrington.
We're not looking to force anything on anybody. What we're doing is just, here's the faith community within this town coming together to celebrate who Jesus is.
Oh, absolutely.
The flag itself isn't the issue.
We have it in our church.
But to people who oppose its flying on public property like Pastor Scott Cady, the concern comes from
Scott
how
Cady
the flag
is not
could be misinterpreted by those with less kind intentions.
Is it a wise thing to do when we know that some people are almost looking for excuses to look down on other faith groups, for example?
I talked to the...
So, wait a second. Once again, is that what we're going to do? Is that what flags do? Suddenly, to give people to look down on other faith groups?
Yeah.
The attorney for the city of Torrington, he declined to go on camera.
Anyway, they got to allow the thing because of what happened in Boston.
Right, which I've talked about before.
Was a violation of the First Amendment. Michelle said that Torrington could attempt to put a local ordinance in place restricting flagpole usage in the future.
Who else is going to show up to put a flag up? You know, if anybody can do it out of their free speech.
In my opinion, it's either you can fly whatever you want, or you fly the American flag and the state flag.
In Torrington, Audrey Russo, Channel 3 Eyewitness News.
There was no mention in 2 minutes and 33 seconds of any other flag that's put up that right. might be controversial. Because there is not one as far as these news people are concerned.
I mean...
there's not one.
Is there any other flag besides the gay flag that gets
Register
the kind of...
Registercitizen.com.
Can I ask
Hold
a question?
On. We're okay. going to get there. This all has to do with the same thing. News. Torrington Pride event stresses inclusiveness. Open conversations. This is from last June. Local and state officials, organizers, and others spoke of courage, honesty, support, and acceptance as the city celebrated the raising of the Pride flag for the first time, June 22. More than 50 people gathered in front of City Hall for the event. Then it says, Johanna Hayes, the congressman, says, it hit me like a ton of bricks, she said. I put down my pen and said, the only thing I need to know is that these are somebody's children. That somewhere in my state, there are mothers who are telling these girls every night, you are important, and I love you. The LGBTQ plus community. No mention of any other flag. This is, the Pride flag is only to be considered a long-time traditional wholly accepted by everybody, non-religious symbol that is just inclusivity, mm-hmm. intolerance, and so it's not to be put on the transom for any kind of critical look whatsoever.
Right. And is there literally any other flag that gets that treatment? So I suppose the prisoner of war missing in action flag is like...
I don't think there's around. A POW month. I don't know.
Well, no, I know, but like that gets flown on flagpoles.
Yes, it right? does.
But like, I mean, I guess maybe more than 30 years ago, maybe like the Confederate flag in the South. But other than
those were state flags generally, right?
Well, no, I think they flew the Confederate flag itself also.
I guess so.
Didn't they on public property?
But with the Confederate flag, there's a backstory to it.
Right.
And people noticed it.
But I'm just wondering, like, is there anything else that municipalities are expected to fly flags for.
No.
Like, was there ever any precedent for going to the town and asking to have your personal viewpoints flag put up? Like, has that ever been a thing? Like, where, you know, activist groups for any cause go and fly flags all the time?
No.
Their own flag?
Just think how complicit the media is that station, Channel 3, would go through 2 minutes and 33 seconds never talking about the real debate.
Right.
Because somebody in there said, wait a second. Well, somebody said, probably said, well, what about the pride flag? Because this religious flag is on, but the pride. And somebody said, it's not the same thing. Don't. It's not the same thing.
Right. And of course, they act like it's not the same thing when that all-Muslim city council in Michigan said they were not going to fly any flags besides the U.S. flag, the state flag, and the POW/MIA flag, that was going to be it, right? And the gay, the Washington Post wrote a whole article about how the gay community felt betrayed because they thought the Muslims were progressive, right? And the Muslims didn't even, like, ban the pride flag in particular. They just said, we're not flying any flags for any viewpoints. But that's, like, an offensive idea to the left.
Mm-hmm.
The idea that you would have a neutral view about the gay pride flag is upsetting to them.
Right.
Or, like, look at Wakefield locally here, where all people asked was that on Flag Day, there be one day when it's just the U.S. flag.
Right.
But they couldn't squeeze in one day of just U.S. flags between Pride Month and Juneteenth. They couldn't make it work for just having the U.S. flag. It's incredible. The idea that there would be, like, viewpoint neutrality beyond and for anything beyond an American flag is, like, that's not acceptable to them.
No. Which is why this is, it just, anyway. So that's part of the insanity. And I'm loving that, okay, that's only going to lead to the end of that town. The end of the experiment of community in towns. Because you're forcing it. You probably half the town's like, what is this? I don't want, but no. They're pretending it's not happening. So you're gaslighting people. You're ignoring them. And saying, oh, it's just a celebration. It's a celebration. We need a month of this. I'm a 26-year-old gay man. I grew up having no troubles, struggles, or anything. I even had a special Gay Straight Alliance club in my high school.
Try middle school. Try elementary.
I've had no struggles. I've lived an upper middle class lifestyle. I get to be celebrated because I've decided, or somebody, nature decided for me, that I like an alternative sex.
Act. Yeah.
So celebrate me. Freaking.
Well, but don't you think that's, like, part of what the left has created by making these, like, hierarchies of victimhood, right? Is, like, how do you, if you are an upper middle class white progressive, how do you get any of the victimhood? Because you're not allowed to talk or say anything or hold any opinions or do anything or lead anything unless you're a victim of something.
And
if you're a rich white progressive, like, what do you have?
Yes.
You know, this is why Andrew Cuomo's daughter has to come out as, what did she come out as? Demisexual.
Right. Well, which also means that you... Right. And you look at stand-up comedian Hasan Minhaj, revealed that many elements of his routines portraying himself to be a victim of racism in America were fabricated, including one where his baby daughter gets anthraxed by somebody. All made up.
Yeah, and including one where he accused a high school girl from his high school's entire family of being racist with enough information to identify them. And that was made up. So, and he's like, oh, well, you know, it's comedy, blah, blah, blah. Well, yeah, but then...
Isn't that the same thing Lena Dunham did? She dated a Republican in college who date raped her?
Probably.
Don't you remember the Lena Dunham book?
Yeah, that does sound vaguely familiar. I just remember her talking about being weird to her sister sexually. Stuff. Creepy, weird person. Oh, I don't like to think about her. The Lauren Boebert thing is still not over, by the way.
Boebert?
Yeah.
Yes.
It's like the left can't let it go. It's so weird to me. I've never seen them this upset about somebody being sexual in public.
Yes, and
they go straight from writing articles about how little kids should see kink at Pride to being upset that Lauren Boebert wore a skimpy dress to a musical.
Yeah, the lack of any self-reflection is absolutely really wild. Beautiful. Here's Howard Stern.
Lauren Boebert is a disgrace to this country, not because of the video. You are 100% right. Forget the politics. She's in a titty dress. If you saw the video, she's in a titty dress. She's with some dude. Looks like she's, you know, obviously vaping, but also looks like she might be grabbing his penis.
First of all, can we just say, you and I are in agreement. I hate. You and I are in agreement that, first of all, it's such a foul gutter term.
Mm-hmm.
Titty.
Yeah, I hate that word.
And by the way, that's
like one of the worst words.
I hate it. I just think it's like a tip.
I think it's.
And by the way, what is he? He's judging her and using that slur about. I mean, and also he's Howard Stern. I mean,
why he's famous?
He's at such
all?
Trash. He sucks.
During Beetlejuice. And he's
Is
playing with her tits.
Is Beetlejuice a sexy play?
It's a very erotic play, evidently. I remember the movie. It was nothing sexy about it.
You didn't grab anybody during the movie.
I guess the play is much hotter. But she was wearing a tight titty dress. I think that porn stars wear more. And this dude that she's with is playing with her titties during it.
God, this guy blows. I don't want to play this anymore. He's a piece of shit. I mean, sorry. He is. I was never a Stern guy.
But, like, imagine being Howard Stern.
Well, right.
With, why he's famous, yes. And the types of stuff he's said and everything. Yeah. And, like, I mean.
He's a juvenile, and he's still doing it right there.
Right. And so what's his problem with Lauren Boebert? I don't understand. Is it women wearing scantily clad
No, because he's a dumb middle-aged woman. He's one of the people in The View now who's just a stupid old person. You know, and it's not, I like old people. He's just a stupid one. He's Joy Behar. That's who he is.
Yeah, I thought the left was sex positive, right?
Yeah, I've got nothing. This is a guy who routinely used the N-word. He's just the biggest POS. And when he was mildly interesting, the moment he got a chance to get entree into the middle class, or upper class, sorry, into the swells, he took it.
Well, but, I mean, look what happens if you don't do that. Look what happens if you're Russell Brand, right?
Well, yeah, or now the guy who did the Patriot, the movie about saving the kids.
Oh.
They're going after him, saying seven women have come forward, too. So but it's on.
It's incredible. The Russell Brand thing's incredible. Not even because I necessarily, I don't know. I don't really care enough to look into the allegations specifically, whatever. He could treat women like garbage, and that's totally plausible. And, you know, I think that a lot of this has been covered. He was a cad, and he's, but it also was quite a while ago, and the media knew about all this stuff that... Right? There's no, new revelation here. They knew he dated a 16-year-old. And it was fine as long as he,
As long as he called George Bush a murderer.
Right. It's the same with Kanye, right? As long as you stay their type of crazy, then they're fine with it, right? You know, and now they've not only, gone after him with all these articles and stuff, but YouTube has actually demonetized his entire channel. Not because he's advocating for dating 16-year-olds or something on the channel, but because they said his offline behavior that's alleged by these women in these articles from, 10, 15, 20 years ago, whatever it is, that is so unacceptable that it's too dangerous to allow him to make any money on the platform by having that. So, I mean, that's quite a standard to have, wouldn't you say?
Yes.
He hasn't even been accused of any crime.
No.
He hasn't been accused of anything criminal. Nobody's filed any charges against him. It's not you're suspended while these charges are being investigated. It's somebody just said something about you from 15 years ago and your YouTube channel gets demonetized. That's a heck of a way to run a business. But that's, I mean, like, that's what they're doing. That's crazy. Nobody should want that to be the standard.
No.
I mean, it's an impossible standard. I mean, I don't know. I don't know what you do with that. Morgan says he has a contract with Rumble. That is true. One of the things that Rumble does is they will also, like, monetize your stuff onto YouTube for you as well.
Oh.
If you set it up that way. So that's something that exists too. But yeah, I mean, like, it's absolutely, like, bizarre. And without any really discussion, there's just, like, total consensus that, like, yep, he's done. Nope, no more YouTube channel for him, right? And the Daily Mail came out with this piece, this opinion piece, by some woman saying that, like, they can't believe his wife is standing by him.
Yes.
Like, what do you mean you can't believe his wife is standing by
him? It's funny, because that came out exactly with the thing about Danny Masterson's wife, saying his wife, she's got tough decisions too, because she's filing for divorce.
Well, he's been accused of a crime in a court of law and convicted. Well, I know, but the jail. Fact that they're trying, like, to equate the two. It's a little different.
I know, but that's the point. The point is they're equating the two. They're the same exact thing. Yep. And the guy who did the movie about child trafficking. Yep. Seven women have come forward and said he was he made them pretend that, like, that they were his real wife or something. It's like, I am sorry. I am I'm out of the believing business when it comes to this stuff anymore. I just am.
Well, and I mean, like, it's possible some of it's true, but my advice...
Sound of Freedom hero Tim Ballard, accused of sexual misconduct against seven women.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I don't know what to do with it anymore, but, like, the truth is, and this, honestly, like, since the Kavanaugh stuff especially, this, like, has to be the standard because that was so transparently... obviously just invented, you know, like the Julie Swetnick, was that her name? And the...
Yes, the Kavanaugh thing?
Yeah, and the Avenatti stuff and all that. Like, that... If you're going to entertain people who are just crazy people who call a tip line and say that somebody raped them who they can't prove they've ever even met, then, you know, then... you make it so that people can no longer, quote, believe all women, right? Because you've made the bar so low for what gets a hearing that you can't, nobody's going to listen to you anymore. It's like a crying wolf thing, right? So now, like, honestly, my advice, if somebody sexually assaults you or violates you in some way, is to go to the police and file a police report.
Against that
person.
Yes.
An attempt to pursue the case and pursue charges. Look, Danny, happened to Danny Masterson. He's a freaking celebrity and they're sending him to prison. So, I mean, like, it's not impossible. I know that every time you say this, oh, that's not possible. You don't understand the pressures women are under, all this stuff, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, which is fine. But then if you don't do that, then you don't get to go out there and, you know, have everybody treat that person like a pariah on the basis of the stuff that you're saying. Because it doesn't, you just don't get to have that if there's not, like, any evidence like that. You know, I don't know what to tell people, but this is the world that you guys put together. So, you know.
Allison, where are you on the hot sauce? Or do you have something you want to get to?
Already ready to go to the hot sauce?
Well, we're at the point.
I feel like there was something else I wanted to talk about, but maybe not.
Elon Musk charging for Twitter?
No, I don't care. I don't think that's really going to happen. Oh, I know. New York City is talking about they're making a task force to...
getting rid of statues of Jefferson, of Washington, and of Lincoln, and all the old people from back then. The founding fathers, all of them, they're getting removed, statues removed. I think it's wonderful. I hope New York burns to the ground. I'm all for this chaos. Mm-hmm. Destroy yourselves further.
They're also looking into reparations for slavery as well.
Do it. Now's a good time, I think. Absolutely. And even new migrants, I think, who are filling up every hotel in town. If those migrants are black, I think they should get reparations for American slavery, even though they weren't here.
Mm-hmm.
I'm all for it. I'm all for it. Make it defunct. And it's fine. I had some good times in New York. You and I did.
Yep.
And so...
So, yeah. So, this includes anybody who owned enslaved persons or benefited economically from slavery or who participated in systemic crimes against indigenous people or other crimes against humanity. So, Columbus is going to go. Peter Stuyvesant is going to go. Christopher Columbus, George Washington. They're going to... And if they decide to leave something up, then they have to include an explanatory plaque. Good.
Like we
to
have
the work
in our town, too, with the Indians. So they have to put a lot of context around a murderous Indian.
Yeah. So they've got to work on that and the reparations, because I think they have a lot of spare money right now with the migrant crisis that our governor is also complaining about, too. Which, this is what worries me about the migrant crisis.
She's getting
crisis
rid of plastic bottles, by the way. That's the big initiative. That's good.
Yeah, she's in state agencies aren't allowed to use plastic bottles anymore, which seems like they'd be useful in a migrant crisis, by the way.
Yep.
But anyway,
no, they should each get their own Yeti.
of course they should. It reminds me of that line in that movie, 1, 2, 3, when she says, when the girl who's dating the communist says that she's given away her fur coat because her boyfriend said that nobody in the world should own 2 fur coats until every woman in the world has 1.
I love it.
So, but yeah, migrant crisis. My worry about the migrant crisis thing, by the way, is that it's not going to get anybody to do anything about the border, but that we're just going to increase a bunch of federal funding to make all these our permanent new friends that live here with us.
We're being overrun. That's the thing with Mnuchin yesterday at the border. Mm-hmm. It's like they're bull rushing all of the Border Patrol people. This is totally out of control. This is... The administration is not doing anything about it. They're pretending gaslighting you. That's what they're doing about it.
With that being said, the hot sauce is the Chelsea Fire Wicked hot sauce. They bring us the Chelsea Fire Wicked hotline where you can leave a chat message for the show.
Shields up in this one, Alice. This one's called Tom's Beard.
Okay.
It's too bad Hervé Villachez from Fantasy Island is no longer with us because he definitely would have found the plane.
Oh, you don't... Okay.
I don't know what that means.
Okay, one thing. I don't know if that's supposed to mean that you're my beard. I think it probably means my actual beard. That's the plane. What was his name on that? Twinkie? What was his name?
I don't know.
Was Ricardo Montalban, Fantasy Island? You don't remember?
I don't know this.
The plane.
I don't have any of this cultural reference.
The plane. Catchphrase, the opening of every side of Fantasy Island. Oh, Fantasy Island moved me. Moved me greatly.
It did?
Because I was little when it was out, so it kind of, my mom would be out somewhere, I don't even know. Oh, yeah, I'm okay. Bill Bixby's a guest star in this one.
Really?
You know who that is?
Nope.
Sandra Dee?
No idea.
There you go. Plane's coming in. Wait for it.
The plane!
That's it. That's Tattoo. He tells Ricardo Montalban that the plane is here. There's some American tourists come in and have a cathartic experience. It's essentially more of a mystical, sometimes serious, love boat on an island. Bill Bixby played the Incredible Hulk when he wasn't the Hulk. You know the Incredible Hulk.
I mean, I know of the character. I don't know that particular iteration of it.
We'll get into it at some other time. There's a lot. Yeah, there's a lot into it. But yeah, it would have been fun. Tattoo would have found the plane. There's no doubt about that. BB.
Burn Brow.
Paul in a car. A simple Claude.
Hey guys, Paul not in the car. This ongoing revelation associated with Claude, the word Claude is fantastic. So keep it going. And I'm not sure if it was the doctor, the good doctor, or somebody else who mentioned clodhopper, but geez, I actually remember that being an insult hurled at people in grade school. And
really?
No one ever really knew what the heck it meant. And here we are all these years later. Uncovering one of the simplest words of all time. Just fascinating. And it's been used in songs, music songs that I've listened to and just never gave it a second thought. And here we are, So good stuff. Keep it up. Thanks.
What's it used in music? Claude. Is
or
it
Claude Hopper?
Is Yakety Yak? Don't come back. Does they say Claude in that one? Maybe. Maybe they do. Take out the papers.
Is it
and
the word Claude or the word Claude Hopper is in music?
I don't know. I don't know. But I didn't expect the Claude voyage either, and it it opened up new wounds, as a matter of fact, for me. Anonymous Alice, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Hi, Alice. To confirm, I am Sicilian.
Here we go.
There we go.
I am Catholic. Mm-hmm. And Tom, I know you won't like this, but I am a lover of black licorice.
Oh, how? How, Steve? Why? How can you be Italian with all that wonderful food and have your palate be dead when it comes to licorice? Oh, oh my goodness. Wally.
Tom, two things that definitely need to be updated.
Yes.
One, have you been to the Orange Julius in Ipswich, Mass yet?
Still have not yet.
And two, where are we with the fat cactus investigation?
I'm asking you, Steve. I've hit a brick wall on, what's our girl there?
Gina.
On Gina. But I want to find out more about her. I've hit a brick wall. As far as the Orange Julius, I would love to go there, no doubt. I'm trying to eat a little better and to lose some weight. But I would definitely whack out some nachos from Orange Julius. We just have to wait till one of the kids is having a sports game
around
there. We're
going to be in Gloucester for a sports game on Saturday.
Well, there you go.
So that's a possibility.
Mark from Canton, Alice.
Okay.
You know Mark?
I don't know that I do know Mark from Canton.
Hey, Tom.
Hey, Mark.
From Canton here.
Hey, Mark.
I think you meeting Wally was a win-win-win for everybody.
Here we go.
Mm-hmm.
Number one, you've got a new drinking partner.
Yes, that is true, I think. I think that's safe to say.
Two, you got somebody that will listen to your lousy guitar playing and maybe help you.
Well, first of all, Mark, do you know my guitar playing? There was a time, and sometimes I can throw a few chords together sometimes. I'm not a good lead player whatsoever. But I could, rhythm guitar wise, I was serviceable. And I'm not talking just, you know, open chords. We're talking about augmented fifths, all sorts of scientific theory-based tablature designs that novices like Alice can only dream of.
Three, you got a new babysitter material for Cyril.
I don't know about that.
I don't know if Wally could handle Cyril.
Yeah, I don't think Wally would survive.
Four, you can finally get all those masonry projects fixed around the house. And probably
that is true.
That actually is true. I would love him to do that. Love him to do that. I could probably just buy him a beverage or something, and he'd maybe throw him a few bucks. I would love him to do that. It's getting worse. Like, the crumbling has crumbled.
They only cost you a 12-pack. And foul, yeah. Number five is you've got a new best friend for Leibowitz. All right, Tom and Alice, have a good day. Bye.
New best friend is for Michael Leibowitz? Oh, I see.
Leibo in Connecticut.
Yeah, right? Yeah. I haven't talked to Leibo in forever. I got to talk to him.
Mm-hmm.
But I think the suggestion is that Wally is an ex-con.
People believe that Wally was, yeah.
And it is not impossible that that is true. He's a great guy,
everybody
though, Wally.
Everybody makes assumptions, though.
Yeah, but even if he was, I wouldn't care. It's fine.
You know what assume does.
Did his strump. Did his stretch. BB.
Burn barrel.
Not in a car.
Okay.
Where are all the ties? What is that? What do you think that means?
I don't know what it means. We'll find out.
Hey, guys. Paul, not in the car.
Hey, Paul.
This dress code thing on the Senate floor. Mm-hmm. Yes. Relative to Fetterman, I mean, good God, it angers me to know.
By the way, very interesting, as you would say, Alice, murder of crows behind Paul. This is the second message where I've heard these crows, these ravens. I wonder if he lives in a very dark neighborhood.
Are you sure they're ravens?
Yeah,
I mean,
listen,
how do you? I mean, I hear the birds, but I don't know that you know how to identify birds by their sound, by the sound.
The untamed heart, Alice. Wait, is that what it's called? The still beating heart.
Telltale
heart. That's right.
Heart. This listen. Dress code thing on the Senate floor relative to Fetterman, mm-hmm. I mean, good God, it angers me to no end. It's just another
another example of how life as we used to know it is just slowly edging away and never to be recovered.
And on some of the stuff Fetterman's been saying, like about her giving a guy a tug or whatever and this and that, he's like, he's a disgusting man in every single way.
Gross.
Yeah.
You know, just in general, all these people working from home and being lazy, not caring. You know, I wear a tie for work still, and I think I'm the only one in the United States that does. I mean,
you might be.
Every time I go into the local butcher, guy's like, the only guy in town who still wears a tie, and we chuckle about it. And I'm kind of like you, Tom, thinking, geez, is this guy taking a dig at me? And I don't realize it, but
yeah.
I feel like we have to hang on to that.
Yes.
This sort of pride that we used to have in representing ourselves is gone. And this Fetterman thing just angers me to no end. Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Paul, I agree with you. I mean, there's the idiot congressman with the cowboy hats, the lady, and there's all sorts of...
Though you like Cinema, who they also adjusted the dress code for her.
Oh,
women
yeah.
Women couldn't go sleeveless.
I have an exception for all the women who are marginally attractive. That's different. That is different.
AOC can wear what she wants.
AOC is encouraged.
To Congress.
I wish she'd dress, you know, more seductively. She could. She doesn't. Shame. Shame. Good BU girl, too. Both her and Howard Stern. BU people.
Wow.
Can you believe that, Alice? Mm-hmm. I bet you he's not talking about her. You know what. Right?
Yeah, I bet.
Anything else you got?
That's all I have today. We'll have to come back and talk more tomorrow. Thank you, as always, for listening. Thank you, Patreon people, for joining us on the live stream. If you want to join that, you can do that at patreon.com/burnbarrel. Of course, you can always watch or listen to the show for free later on. That's at burnbarrelpodcast.com. There's links to the different places to listen on YouTube, on Rumble. I'm all caught up with videos there. So we will see you tomorrow. C'est la vie.